about men cheating, boy. You don't hear the story about the fella? Comes rushing home from work one night, starts to pack all his clothes. He's gonna take off like a bird, and the wife comes in and says, "Where you going?" He says, "I happen to be going down to Australia, where they happen to pay $2 for every time they want a man. Girls are paying this price, and I'm going down there to collect." He says, "Well, well, well." She starts to pack her clothes. He says, "Where are you going?" She says, "I'm going down there to see how long you're going to live on $4 a month." You all right, sir? That's in American money. How long have you kids been married? 9 years. Oh, the stardust isn't out of the eyes yet. 9 years. I think a weekend is about enough, don't you? Because by the time the weekend is over, he's decided that he likes you. And maybe he'll marry you when he gets on his feet. Have you ever had that happen? I guess you wouldn't. You played the whole stakes and the chips were there and you won. My mother always told me to try on a pair of shoes before you buy them. I've tried on so many shoes, my feet are getting big. Ever think about things like that? What about the cute little couple got married? Now, you were married 9 years ago. I wonder if this happened to you. You're through with the wedding and the party and everything, and you're finally sort of very relaxed, and you're up in your hotel room, and this is sort of the first evening together, and you have a few drinks sent up, and whatever was left over from the chicken salad, and, you know, leftover and canapes and junk and everything, and you sort of sit there, and before you know it, he says to you, "Dear, we're married, why don't you go make yourself comfy?" And she says, "Oh, wonderful, I want to get out of these clothes anyway." And she goes in and she showers and bathes and carries on, and she comes out, and she's got a big towel wrapped around her. And he says, "Well, my dear, we are married now. You can drop the towel." And she says, "Well, all righty." And she does, and he goes, "Oh, my heavens." She says, "What's the matter, dear?" He says, "May I take a picture of you?" She says, "Like this?" He says, "What do you want this for?" He says, "I want to carry it close to my heart for the rest of my life." So he takes a picture. And finally, she feels sort of ridiculous sitting there, and he's still in a tuxedo. And she said, "Dear, why don't you go make yourself comfy?" And he goes in, takes a bath, washes up and everything, and he comes out, and he's got a little tea towel around him. And she says, "Well, dear, you know we're married now. You go make yourself comfy. You can drop the towel." And he does. And she goes, "Oh, may I take your picture?" And he flexes his muscles and he says, "Well, yes, dear. What do you want to do with it?" She says, "I want to have it enlarged." Lady. That only takes 60 seconds. Do you ever think about little things that don't matter in the world today? Have you ever thought about that, my dear? Yes, there are so many wonderful people here tonight who more than realize that, you know, there are some people that come in and they listen to some of the things that I say and they say, "Oh my God, what a dirty broad." "Oh, yes, we have 7 ladies come in here on a bus." And they sit down and they listen to the show, and that's exactly what they say. They do. They talk about me and they whisper about me and they go right home and try it all out. You know, you always find out in life it's not what you say, it's how you say it. And it's certainly not what you do, it's how you do it. And I only talk about things that you do all the time. I don't do it. I'd love to, but they're afraid to ask me. They think, "Oh, she's so sharp. You know, just like that, she'll probably say no." I never say no. The only time I say no is when they've asked me if I've had enough. I mean, it's silly, but it's true. All you wonderful people just sitting out there with your husbands and everything, and you don't care what happens to me. You sit out there and married to a man for 9 years, and you know he won't cheat because he still loves you. He's mesmerized. You've kept yourself beautiful. You're a very nice-looking gal. You got a little mink, dear. You work hard, and next year you'll get the whole coat, dear. Nice. Oh, no, we have quite a few of those mixed around here tonight. It's nice of you to come down here in this particular area of Florida and wear the kosher windbreaker. It's sort of funsies. But we, of course, we girls figure that we have a lot to project in this world today. Every one of us feel that, after all, if these men are campaigning to give the best that they have, then we, of course, must campaign to give the best of what we have. So, if I may, I would like to do a number for the young ladies to prove that we do have something to give. Are you girls ready?